What's going on, guys? It's dinner time. So, it's Dr. Katie here, TheDollarChallengeClub.com. I am here. My goal, everything I want to do for you, is to show you how to start, sustain a healthy, whole food, clean eating lifestyle without breaking the bank or without going crazy, making this lifestyle fit into your schedule, your life. Okay. One of the things that I talk about all the time, so anybody that has been following me for any length of time knows that the one thing that I believe in more than anything is, if anybody knows it, go ahead and type it, ingredient sharing. It is my absolute favorite thing ever. So ingredient sharing, if you don't know what that is basically the idea of cooking a lot of one thing, but using those same ingredients multiple ways. So again, I'm making dinner right now, and I figured this is the perfect time to show you exactly what that means. So one thing that I make, oh, that's hot. One thing that I make all the time is this pizza spaghetti squash casserole. Again, if you've been following me for any length of time, you're like, oh my gosh, Katie, enough with this pizza casserole. You make it all the freaking time. I know I do, because I know how to make it. I know I like it. I know my family likes it. There is no thought involved whatsoever. It's simple. Don't overcomplicate it. But with this casserole, I baked one big spaghetti squash. The other half is thrown away. And I used most of that squash to go into my casserole, okay? You following me? And you'll see in here, I've got about one cup that I'm not gonna put in the casserole, but I'm gonna save it, because what I'm gonna do with it, hi Rowan, at Rowan over there eating her veggies. What I'm gonna do with this squash is I make these freaking delicious spaghetti squash hash browns, I call them. So it's literally, it's a cup of this squash. Before you actually make the squash browns, I like to call them, you want to kind of squeeze them out with like a clean dish rag or cheesecloth, just to get kind of the extra moisture out. One egg, sea salt and pepper, and then you make them into little fritters and you fry them in coconut oil. They are so easy and they're so delicious. I actually kind of like the way they taste better than regular hash browns. No lie. So I'm saving this. You know, I only cooked one squash. This was no extra work. But I have this for tomorrow's breakfast or the next day's breakfast, whichever day I'm feeling ambitious. What? So I have this saved. So one meal, 6 to 8 servings. Another meal that will feed both me and my 3-year-old. Okay, so second part of this equation is this ground beef. So it's a pound of ground beef. I usually do get grass-fed ground beef. That's the one thing that I spend a little bit of extra money to get the good stuff. I put probably a little more than 3/4 a pound of ground beef into my casserole. I'm gonna save the rest again. And what I do with it, I do a ton of stuff with this. Not a ton, there's not like a lot here to work with. But when I do have extra, I'll use it a couple of different ways. I'll throw it into my scrambled eggs along with some other veggies just to get some extra protein in there. I will sometimes make Andrew like a mac and cheese and I'll add it in there. There's a bunch of stuff that you can do that's for some reason not coming to my mind right now. Actually, sometimes I eat this just plain with like sauteed garlic spinach on the side, and like that's my dinner and it's delicious. So a ton of stuff you can do with just plain ground beef. And again, I just cooked two things. That's all I did. But I'm getting all these different meals out of just cooking these two super easy things. I mean, like, how hard is ground beef to cook? It's not hard at all. How hard is spaghetti squash to cook? You just stab it and then you put it in the oven. It's like, boom, so easy. Bam. So I'm gonna put those in my fridge, and then to finish making this, so actually you can get this whole recipe. This is literally, this concept is straight out of week 2 of my 30-day dollar challenge. It is out of week 2. You are making this. It really lets you practice and put this ingredient sharing to your use, your benefit, your practice, so you can learn what this lifestyle is all about. So make sure that, if you've done this, I know anybody out there that has tried pizza, spaghetti, squash casserole, and squash browns, let me know how you like them, because I know you love it and I want to hear from you. If you have not tried it, you get these two recipes plus a ton of other ones plus a ton of other stuff. It's $1. I have the link up there, so grab it if you haven't. And to make the rest of this, so it's just the squash, the ground beef. This is just pasta sauce, which I got at Aldi. Like, I don't get fancy stuff and I don't think you should either. Don't overthink it too much. And I'm throwing that in there. Sometimes I do the whole jar. Let's do the whole jar. And I mix it up. And actually, if you want this to be where you can like slice it into pieces, you also add in a couple of whisked eggs. And that'll make it sliceable. but I'm on a time crunch. I have something to do tonight, so I'm gonna make it so I don't need to cook it for quite as long. It still tastes good, it just kind of comes out more like a big goop. You know, it doesn't always matter how it looks, right? So I'm not adding the eggs, but I am going to be a little crazy and I'm gonna add a little bit of cheese to the top, a little bit of mozzarella cheese. But this, again, my son loves this. It's like the easiest way. If you have kids that don't like vegetables, dude, this is like, I call this my gateway meal to healthy eating. Pizza, spaghetti, squash, casserole. I've given this to people that are like, I hate vegetables. I don't eat healthy. Blah, blah, blah. Meat and potatoes, beef sandwiches, blah. And they'll eat this and they like it. So, this is your recipe. If you are having trouble like converting your family into eating healthy, this is the one you have to try. And again, if you have to add the cheese, add a little bit of cheese. Not gonna kill anyone. But it actually tastes really good, believe it or not, without the cheese. It's not like 100% necessary. Why is this taking me 48 hours to get this damn cheese on? And then you bake it. If you have the egg in, you have to bake it a little bit longer. That's why I said I'm on a time crunch. It's like 40 minutes at 400. I'm only gonna bake this for like 20, 25 minutes. Oh. Rowan needs to get more veggies, so I gotta get this in, so I gotta dash. Again, this is week two of my 30-day dollar challenge. Grab it if you haven't. Link is up above me. And I hope I see you in the next challenge. Okay, the natives are restless. I gotta go. All right, have a good night, guys. Oh, Kathy knows what's up. Pizza casserole is lummy. Yes, it is. You rock, Kathy. You sound a lot better. Yes, I'm getting there, Dana. Thank you. Medicine is a wonderful thing. So, all right, have a great night, guys. Thanks for watching.